Welcome to the Agilent eSoft EDA demo on the ADS load pool utility. The load pool measurement data import utility allows you to import data, convert measured data, and perform AC simulation to optimize power amplifier matching networks. We will demonstrate how to import measured data, convert measured data, and use this measured data with an AC simulation to generate load pool contours for any measured parameter. The load pool measurement data import utility is located under the load pool application guide. The load pool utility will allow you to import measured load pool data from MORI and focus load pool systems into ADS and generate load pool contours. One can import measured data by using the Select Load Pool Data File button and by selecting the load pool data file using the browser. The utility will read the measured load pool data file and make appropriate settings for the data format dialog box. It will also prompt you to enter the output file name. The measured data needs to be processed using the Prepare Load Pool Data button. During the processing of measured load pool data, a triangular mesh is generated between load pool data points. When the data is processed, all the load pool parameters will appear in the measurement variable window. Now, to generate load pool contours, the user needs to select the load pool parameters from the measurement variables window and add it to the trace window. During this process, the user can specify the start and stop boundaries and specify the number of contours. Load pool contours of multiple parameters can also be generated simultaneously. Now we can extract the load pool contours from the measured data by pressing the Generate Contour button. Now we will plot the load pool contours in the data display window. Here we're plotting the load pool contours corresponding to the output power and the power gain by the device. And in addition to load pool contour plots, the utility will also allow you to plot discrete data. We can also extract a behavior model from the measured load pool data by using the Behavior Model tab in the load pool utility. To extract the behavior model from measured data, the user needs to map the load pool parameter names corresponding to input power, transducer gain, SOI, and TOI. After defining the input power range, a behavior model can be extracted using the Generate Behavior Model button. During this process, the scatter data is converted into a rectangular polar grid data using a low pool harmonic balance simulation. The grid data is converted into a data set which can later be used with AMP load pool model. The model verification tab allows you to select low pool harmonic balance simulation of the extracted behavior model. The user can specify the low pool simulation parameters and a harmonic balance low pool test bench can be set up using the Setup Verification Schematic button. The low pool test bench will connect the power source to the AMP low pool model, which is terminated into a varying load impedance. The extracted behavior model dataset is mapped to the AMP low pool model. Upon simulation, the data display template will plot low pool contours on the output power. One can specify the power step and the number of low pool contours to be plotted on the Smith chart. The low pool measurement data simulation option under Model Verification tab allow you to perform AC low pool simulations of measured data. The user can specify simulation parameters and create a test bench using Setup Verification Schematic button. The AC low pool test bench connects an AC source, a current probe which is terminated into a varying load termination. The equation shows on the schematic page will vary from the low reflection coefficient in a circular region on the Smith chart. The low pool utility will also place a set of variables and measurement equations. The measured low pool data is accessed using the data access component and the variable equations. So during the low pool simulation, the output reflection coefficient is determined and the corresponding output low pull parameters are generated. This simulation will also allow you to plot low pull contours of any measured low pull parameter. The user does need to specify the low pull parameter name, the step size, and the number of contours in the data display template. Now we've seen how to use the low pull measurement data import utility in ADS. Thank you for watching this Agilent EaseOff EDA demo.